Sat Sri Akal, welcome to the lesson 8th in our series. We will begin with some introduction to retroflex sounds. We have already introduced, but we have to repeat again. First, I read two paragraphs from Professor Gleason's presentation. He says, Punjabi ta da na. Ta, da, na are retroflex sounds. You see, these are retroflex. This is just a technical term, but what it means is, this means that they are pronounced with the tip of the tongue turned slightly back and touching the roof of the mouth a little behind the gums. Again, this means that they are pronounced with the tip of the tongue turned slightly back and touching the roof of the mouth a little behind the gums. Punjabi ta is slightly further back than the English ta. Da and ana are pronounced with the same tongue position as ta. That means all three Punjabi ta, da, na, the position of the tongue remains the same in all these three. English ta, da, na are commonly retroflex when they follow ra, as in bird, bird, burn. See, this ta, da, na is quite back. They are more like these only when they are pronounced after ra. As a matter of fact, ra is not pronounced in English. This is bird. You see, it is ra is very, worst a little bit. Bird, burn. Okay, this is the function of ra primarily is to take it back, take the following consonant back. So, they are only, so this is what happens is that when the British or the Americans hear ta, da, na, they think that there is also a ra here, because their ta, da, na, when they are retroflex, when they are quite back, they are practically, they are always after ra. So, this is a, so which means that the Punjabi ta da na and the English ta da na are not the same. In some positions like after ra, they give the impression of being the same, but they are not same. For Punjabis, now there are, as I said, there is a distinction between dental sound and retroflex sound. See, ta and da, both are dental. Ta, da, they are, these two sounds are practically the same as in French, ta, da. And then there is ta and da. And then there is also tha and ta and tha. You see, you have dental, retroflex, dental plus aspiration, retroflex plus aspiration. You see, these are dental, that means the tongue touches the teeth. This is a retroflex, this is back. These are dental plus aspiration, aspirate, and this dental, this is retroflex plus aspirate. So these are four distinctions in Punjabi. So we have now, we will have some words where this distinction is shown or made. For example, we can have a word like moti and also a word like moti. You will see they are quite different, because moti is pearl, beads, moti is somebody who is fat, see, is feminine, a fat girl. So then you have this is ta and ta, and then you can have modi, and you can have modi. In this particular case, you also have a tone. Modi is accountant, and modi is a leader or somebody who leads, or who comes in, you know, in front. These are different words. Moti, moti, modi, modi. Again, moti, moti, modi, modi. Now you have some more words. You have jat, and you can have a jat. You have lat and lat, and on the other hand, you have sadi and sadi, sadi. You can have lad and kad, for example, lad, lad, kad. You see, these are different words, jat, wool or something, jat, one of the castes. Lat, leg, and lat can be some other thing. And so sadi ours, sadi is simple, and sadi is ours, simple, ours. See, the main idea is that they are quite different words. For the time being, all you have to know is the different, how you pronounce them. Or even you can have kad, for example, this would have been here. You can even say kad, kad is height, and kad is to take out. So they are different words. See, jat, jat, lat, lat, sadi, sadi, kad, kad. You see, you have these words. Then you have tha. You see, tha and tha, dental aspirated and retroflex aspirated. You see, this one is a dental aspirate, and so you have a word like thok, and then you have thok. You see, you have teak, and you have theek. These are very different words. They are nothing to do with each other. See, thap and thap. Anyway, there are so many. The idea is thok is a lot of things, and thok is to hammer. Teak, this you leave it. You see, tap, thap, tok, thok, 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 thap, thap. Or you have chauth, and you have chaut. Here you have but there is also a tone chauth, fourth, chauth is 64. So you can imagine the difference between here it is 64 and this becomes 64 if you add like that. So this means the meanings of words change considerably, okay, not small differences. Now I'll for a little more practice for on tone, we'll three tones. You see, there is a mid, and you can say we write here mid and high and low. You see, these are three tones. So you have word like la, and you have la, and you have word like la. You have cha, cha, and cha. You see, cha is enthusiasm, cha is tea, cha is to peep, to. You see, then you have standard example that you always give, koda, and koda, and koda. You see, this is a whip, this is a leopard, and this is a horse. So, you see how distinct the meanings are. You see, just the change of the tone or the pitch on the vowel makes a very clear distinction between one word and the other. You see? So, tones are very, very important. So, you have to keep on repeating and pronouncing them again and again. For example, you have na, na, and na. You have tir, tir, and tir. You have kal, 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 and kal. See? Okay, just these to practice. Na, na, na. Here you can, you have even a bit of a, I mean, anyway, after na, the vowel is automatically nasalized. Na, na, na. You see, na is no, na is to take bath, tir, arrow, tir, 13, 13, tira, tir is threefold sometimes, and tir is to be steady, to be slow, you see, to have patience. Kal, kal is when there is a drought, and there is a kal, kal is to hurry up, to be in a hurry, and kal is hard work. So they are different words. So again, we will pronounce them na, 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 tir, 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 kal, kal, kal. See? So you have some practice in this pronunciation. Now we will try to use some words, some sentences where there is a, the same words, for example, koda and koda and koda, put it in a small sentence. See, o koda hai. See, or the same thing, o koda hai. I mean, they are not very good sentences, but the sentences are all the same. See, ਉਹ ਕੋੜਾ ਹੈ। ਐਕਚੁਲੀ ਵੀ ਸਟਾਰਟ ਵਿਦ ਦਿਸ ਐਂਡ ਵੀ ਮੇਕ ਇਟ ਲਾਈਕ ਦਿਸ। ਇੰਸਟੈਡ ਆਫ ਸੇਇੰਗ ਜਸਟ ਕੋੜਾ ਕੋੜਾ ਕੋੜਾ, ਉਹ ਕੋੜਾ ਹੈ, ਉਹ ਕੋੜਾ ਹੈ, ਉਹ ਕੋੜਾ ਹੈ। ਸੀ ਇਟ ਵੈਨ ਇਟ ਕਮਸ ਇਨ ਬਿਟਵੀਨ ਅ ਸੈਂਟੈਂਸ, ਦੈਨ ਇਫ ਆਈ ਫੋਲੋ ਦੀ ਪ੍ਰੋਨਾਸੀਏਸ਼ਨ, ਇਫ ਆਈ ਸਿੰਪਲੀ ਸੇ ਕੋੜਾ ਕੋੜਾ ਕੋੜਾ, ਐਂਡ ਦੈਨ ਆਈ ਪ੍ਰੋਨਾਊਂਸ ਉਹ ਕੋੜਾ ਹੈ, ਉਹ ਕੋੜਾ ਹੈ, ਉਹ ਕੋੜਾ ਹੈ, ਸੋ ਦੀ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਨੋਟ ਐਗਜੈਕਟਲੀ ਦੀ ਸੇਮ ਪ੍ਰੋਨਾਸੀਏਸ਼ਨ, ਬਟ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਟੂ ਗੈਟ ਯੂਜ ਟੂ ਦ ਪ੍ਰੋਨਾਸੀਏਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਵਰਡਸ ਇਨ ਅ ਸੈਂਟੈਂਸ। ਵੈਨ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਏ ਲੌਂਗੁਏਜ ਸੈਂਟੈਂਸ ਦੈਨ ਇਟ ਚੇਂਜਿਸ, ਫੋਰ ਐਗਜ਼ਾਮਪਲ ਨਾਓ ਵੀ ਵਿਲ ਈਵਨ ਮੇਕ ਐਡ ਏ ਲਿਟਲ ਵਨ ਐਡਜੈਕਟਿਵ ਚੰਗਾ, ਫੋਰ ਐਗਜ਼ਾਮਪਲ ਵਿਲ ਸੇ ਵਨ ਮੋਰ ਵਰਡ, ਸੀ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ, ਇਟਸ ਏ ਗੁੱਡ ਹੋਰਸ ਔਰ ਏ ਗੁੱਡ ਗੁੱਡ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ, ਚੰਗਾ ਮੀਨਸ ਗੁੱਡ, ਉਹ ਕੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ, ਉਹ ਕੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ, ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ। ਸੀ ਵੈਨ ਯੂ ਐਡ ਅਨਦਰ ਵਰਡ ਦੀ ਸੈਂਟੈਂਸ ਬਿਕਮਸ ਲੌਂਗ, ਦੈਨ ਦੀ ਇੰਟੋਨੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਦਿਸ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਸੀ ਹਾਊ ਯੂ ਪ੍ਰੋਨਾਊਂਸ ਦਿਸ 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 ਮੈਟਰਸ, ਔਰ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਈਵਨ ਪ੍ਰੋਨਾਊਂਸ ਦੀ ਸੇਮ ਵਿਦ ਵਿਦ ਅ ਹੈਰ, ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ, ਇਜ਼ ਇਟ ਏ ਗੁੱਡ ਹੋਰਸ, ਸੀ ਹੋਰਸ ਫੋਰ ਐਗਜ਼ਾਮਪਲ ਘੋੜਾ, ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ, ਜਾਂ ਉਹ ਇਫ ਆਈ ਸੇ ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ, ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਗੁੱਡ ਹੋਰਸ, ਇਫ ਆਈ ਸੇ ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ, ਸੀ ਇਟ ਮੀਨਸ ਇਜ਼ ਇਟ ਏ ਗੁੱਡ ਹੋਰਸ, ਸੀ ਸੋ ਐਂਡ ਇਨ ਦੀ ਪ੍ਰੋਸੈਸ ਯੂ ਸੀ ਇਫ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਦਿਸ ਸੈਂਟੈਂਸ ਇਟਸ ਅ ਗੁੱਡ ਸੈਂਟੈਂਸ, ਦਿਸ ਸੈਂਟੈਂਸ ਕੈਨ ਬੀ ਪ੍ਰੋਨਾਊਂਸਡ ਇਨ ਟੂ ਵੇਸ, ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ, ਦਿਸ ਮੀਨਸ ਅ ਸਿੰਪਲ ਸਟੇਟਮੈਂਟ ਇਟਸ ਅ ਗੁੱਡ ਹੋਰਸ, ਬਟ ਆਈ ਕੈਨ ਸੇ ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ, ਯੂ ਸੀ ਦੈਨ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਹੇਅਰ ਐਂਡ ਦੈਨ ਇਟ ਗੋਜ਼ ਅਪ, ਯੂ ਸੀ ਦੀ ਇੰਟੋਨੇਸ਼ਨ ਗੋਜ਼ ਅਪ ਐਂਡ ਦੈਟ ਬਿਕਮਸ ਏ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ, ਬਟ ਇਨ ਬੋਥ ਕੇਸਿਸ ਵਟ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਟੂ ਸੀ ਇਜ਼ ਨੋਟ ਸਿੰਪਲੀ ਦੈਟ ਇਟਸ ਸੀ ਦੀ ਇੰਟੋਨੇਸ਼ਨ ਗੋਜ਼ ਅਪ, the pronunciation of these words, these consonants and vowels also changes, you see in the sentence o koda changa hai, there is an emphasis on koda or changa, o koda changa hai, you can say o, you see it depends on how you pronounce, you can say o koda changa hai, that horse is good, you see, or you can say o koda changa hai, that horse is good, see you understand the point, that whether you are emphasizing the horse or you are emphasizing the verbal phrase, you see this is a verbal phrase, you see this is a noun, you see that horse is good, it can be pronounced in several ways, you can pronounce is o koda changa hai, you can pronounce o koda changa hai, or you can pronounce o koda changa hai, or o koda ਉਹ ਕੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ, ਸੀ ਯੂ ਐਟਲੀਸਟ ਦੇਰ ਆਰ ਫੋਰ ਰਿਦਮਸ ਫੋਰ ਇੰਟੋਨੇਸ਼ਨ ਪੈਟਰਨਸ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਸੇਮ ਸੈਂਟੈਂਸ, ਸੈਂਟੈਂਸ ਕੈਨ ਬੀ ਅਫਰਮੇਟਿਵ, ਕੈਨ ਬੀ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ, ਕੈਨ ਹੈਵ ਐਮਫੇਸਿਸ ਔਨ ਵਨ ਔਰ ਦੀ ਅਦਰ ਡਿਪੈਂਡਿੰਗ, ਸੀ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਐਮਫੇਸਾਈਜ਼ ਕੋੜਾ ਦੈਨ ਯੂ ਰੇਜ਼ ਯੂਅਰ ਪਿੱਚ ਹੀਅਰ and lower your pitch on the following word, or if what is important is it's being good, then you raise the pitch there, and consequently see that the real problem is the consequent, when you change your pitch, you when the rhythm of the intonation changes, then all the vowels and consonants, especially the vowels, they will not be pronounced in the same manner, okay, if you record it properly, and this is why if a non-native, a person whose language is not Punjabi, he, for him, there will be lot of differences. Whereas for a Punjabi speaker, each time it is the same word in the same sentence, only the slightly the pitch is changed, because you are used to your words and your sentences and your vowels and consonants, and you don't, you see, we don't read. Punjabis don't read, they know, they speak. You see, it is the spoken part that is more important than the written part. So, and this is why it is a, or you can change it, like for example, or you can even say, you see, the same thing. You see, there are so many possibilities. You see, or we can say, ਘੋੜਾ ਬਹੁਤ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਫਸਟ ਟੂ ਬਿਗਿਨ ਵਿਦ ਓਨਲੀ ਦਿਸ ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ ਦੈਟ ਹਾਰਸ ਇਜ਼ ਗੁੱਡ ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਬਹੁਤ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ ਦੈਟ ਹਾਰਸ ਇਜ਼ ਵੈਰੀ ਗੁੱਡ ਸੀ ਦੈਨ ਯੂ ਨਾ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਓਬਜੈਕਟਿਵ ਫਰੇਸ ਐਂਡ ਐਕਚੁਲੀ ਇਟਸ ਏ ਵਰਬ ਫਰੇਸ ਯੂ ਸੀ ਇਟ ਹੈਜ਼ ਐਨ ਓਬਜੈਕਟਿਵ ਬਟ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਏ ਵਰਬ ਫਰੇਸ ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਬਹੁਤ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ ਸੀ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਦਿਸ ਐਬਜੈਕਟਿਵ ਪਲੱਸ ਵਰਬ ਫਰੇਸ ਬਹੁਤ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਨਾਓ ਦ ਐਮਫੇਸਿਸ ਵਿਲ ਬੀ ਔਨ ਦਿਸ ਬੋਥ ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਬਹੁਤ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ ਸੀ ਦੈਨ ਹਾਓ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਪ੍ਰੋਨਾਊਂਸਿੰਗ ਇਟ ਦਿਸ ਵੇ ਸੀ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਦਿਸ ਵੇ ਯੂ ਗੋ ਅਪ ਐਂਡ ਦੈਨ ਯੂ ਗੋ ਡਾਊਨ ਸੀ ਓਨ ਦੀ ਫਸਟ ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ ਦੈਨ ਯੂ ਸੇ ਜੇਫ ਯੂ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਐਮਫੇਸਾਈਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਦੈਨ ਇਟ ਵਿਲ ਗੋ ਗਾਈ ਲਾਈਕ ਦੈਟ ਔਰ ਇਫ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਏ ਕੁਸ਼ਚਨ ਮਾਰਕ ਦੈਨ ਇਟ ਵਿਲ ਗੋ ਲਾਈਕ ਦਿਸ ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਘੋੜਾ ਬਹੁਤ ਚੰਗਾ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਸੇ ਉਹ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਈਵਨ ਚੇਂਜ ਦੀ ਆਰਡਰ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਸੇ ਉਹ ਚੰਗਾ ਘੋੜਾ ਹੈ ਸੀ ਦ ਐਬਜੈਕਟਿਵ ਚੰਗਾ ਗੁੱਡ not it's not necessary that it should come afterwards you can say good horse you see you can say that horse is good or it's a good horse you see it is oh changa koda hai you see that means that this now the phrase is here you see then changa goes with koda whereas here it goes with bahut changa you see the sentence structure is also different but what I want to emphasize now is not necessarily the how this sentence is structured but with each difference in the structure of the sentence when the order of the words change the intonation patterns change and consequently the quality of the vowels change considerably consonants also but not to that much generally the consonants are more stable but the vowels are liquid vowels change considerably depending upon the intonation depending upon the emphasis now that is these are again we learn a little bit about you see like we in the earlier sentences I said you see unne pani pita ਸੀ ਹੀ ਡਰੈਂਕ ਵਾਟਰ ਉਹਨੇ ਪਾਣੀ ਪੀਤਾ ਏ ਉਹਨੇ ਪਾਣੀ ਪੀਤਾ ਸੀ ਉਹਨੇ ਪਾਣੀ ਪੀ ਲਿਆ ਉਹ ਪਾਣੀ ਪੀ ਗਿਆ ਨਾਓ ਆਲ ਦੀਸ ਆਰ ਪਾਸਟ ਟੈਂਸ ਫੋਰਮੇਸ਼ਨਸ ਨੋਰਮਲੀ ਇਟ ਮੀਨਸ ਹੀ ਡਰੈਂਕ ਵਾਟਰ but this is the most normal sentence unne pani pita he drank water unne pani pita hai you see this is now as I said, this is sort of is and this is sort of was, but does not mean anything. You see, as a matter of fact, if you think of is and was here, you will not understand anything. Unne pani pita hai, he has drunk, this means it is little more than this past, it is little more past. Unne pani pita si, he drank water, or he drank water sometime back. So, the degree of past tense, you see, the degree of past tense, this is number 1, this is 2, this is 3. You see, this is more past, little less, this is past, little more past and little more past. Then we have two more formations. Unne pani pi liya. You see, it is like he drank water, he has finished drinking water, or he is like saying where is the water, or water is not there or something, then you say, oh, he has drunk it. You see, it is, you see, this is why the context is different. In one thing, in one instance the constant is he drank water, in the other, in this context is water is not there because he has drunk it, so there is no there. And in this case also, there is a difference of degree. If you say unne pani pi liya, liya means taken. In this case, liya literally means taken, you see, which of course has no meaning here. And gaya means went, you see. Again, it does not mean anything. They are just emphatic, you see. So, but see, these are only very deceptive terms. Unne pani pi liya, which means there is no water. O pani pi gaya, means he was not supposed to drink water, but he drank water and sort of ran away or went away. O pani pi gaya, that means he was, see, you must realize there are so many possibilities of presenting the same case. You have 3 degrees here, 2 degrees here, and maybe even more. You can say, you can present past tense in 4-5 manners. Sometimes it is little less past, it is more past, and still further past. But there is no equivalent. You cannot have any equivalent in English. You cannot say he drank, he did drink, or he had drunk. See, all these again will not make much sense to Punjabis also. Or see, or what happens is that Punjabis will try to translate to when they will speak English, they will try to say the same thing as they say in Punjabi. Of course, it does not work because the grammar of English and grammar of Punjabi are entirely 2 different grammars, and the past, both have, there is a past tense. So, this is why the problem, because there is past tense in English and there is a past tense in Punjabi, but the 2 past tenses do not correspond with each other. In each case, there is slightly more, slightly less, and it is the context in general that will explain how these tenses function. Okay. So, to understand one sentence, you have to have the whole context. You see, it is in a situation that you understand these, see, for example, in future, I mean, jayega, we will take jayega, see, we just said jayega. Now, jayega otherwise normally means he will go, see, wo jayega, he will go, wo jayega, he will go. But if you say wo chala jayega, again there is a degree of difference of degree. Wo jayega, he will go, wo chala jayega, of course he will go. You see, chalna means also to walk. You see, that twice jayega, in a way chalna means go, chala gaya, you can say he went away. But you add, you see, you, or even you see, when you, for example, you say, since we have introduced past tense, we can say here, wo chala gaya. See, jana Gya is past of jana, you see. So, O jayega, he will go. O chala jayega, of course he will go. O chala gya, of course he has gone already. You see, he has gone, he has gone away. You see, if you ask him where is he, O chala gya, he is gone. So, me there are different categories, different shades of the same tense. Now, in terms of, for example, pina, pina, khana, o piega, first is a piega, you see, he will drink, or we can say, cha piega, he will drink tea. But if you say, O pi jayega, it's different. O piega, he will drink. O pi jayega, that also means he will drink. But he will drink away, kind of, don't bother. He is going to drink away. He will drink and kind of go away, kind of thing. O pi jayega, he will. You see, it is much more emphatic than O piega. O piega, he will drink. O pi jayega, even semantically, it is emphasis on pi jayega, that he will take away, he will drink, he will finish everything. See? Or similarly, you can have O khayega. You see, O khayega, that means he will eat, like he will drink. But if you say O kha jayega, you see, which is very different. O khayega, he will eat. Khayega, I mean, he will eat his bread or lunch. But O kha jayega, it may mean, so, because this is emphatic, he will eat away. Or he will even take away everything that you have. Kha jayega, he will, you see, this kha, then kha, khana is to eat, like pee is to peena. Then this emphasis will not only emphasize the degree of future, but also bring some change in the semantic structure of the language, of the sentence. You see, or one more very interesting sentence, O dodega. Dodega means he will run. He will run. But if you say O dor jayega, this means he will run away. You see, O dorega, dorna is to run. O dorega, he will run. But O dor jayega, he will run away. Like he will, O pi jayega, he will drink and go away. Or kha jayega, he will eat and go away. You see, so by changing the structure of the sentence, and remaining within the same formation of future or past or present, there are a number of shades of present, number of shades of past, number of shades of future, and each new formation leads to different meanings grammatically and also semantically. This is why you see, in the beginning we concentrated on pronunciation, and we introduced vowels, consonants, tones, and some present, past, future, these tenses. But already I have given you an introduction to the complexities in each tense of formation. And so this is where we will end our lesson today, and in our next lesson we will introduce the Gurmukhi script. This Punjabi is written in Gurmukhi. I did not introduce Gurmukhi script to begin with, because I wanted you to have a good idea of the pronunciation of the language, and the idea was to follow the pattern of language learning the way children learn language. Children first learn the spoken variety of the language and then the written variety. So, we will follow the same pattern, and next time we will introduce Gurmukhi orthography writing system and then show how it works, how it corresponds to sounds, where there are problems and where there are agreements or disagreements. And so, this is that will be our ninth lesson next time. Thank you.